टाइप कन्वर्शन और टाइप कास्टिंग। टाइप कन्वर्शन और टाइप कास्टिंग रेफर्स टू चेंजिंग एन एंटिटी ऑफ वन डेटा टाइप इनटू अनदर। इट इज यूज्ड इन कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग टू एंश्योर वेरिएबल्स आर करेक्टली प्रोसेस्ड बाय अ फंक्शन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कन्वर्टिंग अ फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट नंबर टू एन इंटीजर। दिस माइट बी यूज्ड टू परफॉर्म कैलकुलेशंस मोर एफिशिएंटली व्हेन द डेसिमल प्रिसिशन इज अननेसेसरी। There are two types, implicit type conversion and explicit type conversion. Implicit type conversion, implicitly converting a variable from one data type to another, that is conversion of data types without losing its original meaning. This type of type casting is essential when we want to change data types without changing the significance of the values stored inside the variable. So this is automatically done by the compiler, that is when a value is copied to its compatible data type. For example, in this program the value of x is 10 and for character c we are assigning the alphabetical letter k and we are considering the variable total, its data type is float. Now we are adding two variables, that is total is equal to x plus c. So here the value of x is 10. For c we have the value k, that is nothing but the ASCII value of character k is assigned to variable c. So the ASCII value of small letter alphabetical letter k is 107. So 107 plus 10, that is totally 117. So this value is assigned to a variable total. Now total is floating point data type, so print total, that is percentage f is a format specifier of float. So now total is equal to 117.6 zeros, that is nothing but it is displaying the value in floating point position. Explicit type conversion, it requires type casting operator. Syntax for this is type name expression. Here type name is the standard C language data type. Expression can be a constant, a variable or any standard expression. So in this program float is equal to 1.3, then y is equal to int of x plus 2, then print the value of x and y. So here we have initialized a variable x is equal to 1.3. It is of type float. Next we have another variable y of integer data type. Since the variable x and y are of different data types, C won't allow the use of such expression and it will raise an error. So for example, if you write y is equal to x, it shows an error. In some version of C, the expression will be evaluated, but the result will not be the desired one. To avoid such situations, we have typecast the variable x of type float. By using this explicit typecasting methods, we have successfully converted float into data type integer. Then we have printed the value of x, which is still a float. After typecasting, the result will always be an integer y. So here value of x is 1.300000. So that is a floating point value. Value of y is integer, that is 3. So that is x is 1.3, but since we have converted that floating point into integer, it takes a complete number. 0.3 is truncated, so 1 plus 2, that is 3. So finally the value of y is 3.
Precedence and associativity. This concept is applicable during evaluation of an expression. An expression is a sequence of operands and operator which reduces to a single value. An operator is a symbol that performs arithmetic and logical operations. An operand can be a variable or a constant on which the operation is performed. For example, x is equal to y plus z, where equal and plus are the operators. X, y, and z are the operands. An expression can be a variable, constant, or any formula that uses operators. So these are the operators which are used in C language. So that is bracket, arrow mark, plus, minus, multiplications, equal, less than, greater than. So all these are the arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators. So this is the associativity of this operators. Like this table shows you the precedence and associativity of operators. So this particular bracket has highest priority. So when you have the same operators, the same expression, then we need to follow left to right associativity. So this is the operators, and then this column indicates the corresponding associativity. Next, we'll see some of the rules for evaluation of an expression. Parent size sub expression from left to right are evaluated. When we have n number of parentheses in an expression, we need to follow left to right associativity. If parentheses are nested, the evaluation begins with the innermost sub expression. The precedence rule is applicable in determining the order of application of operators in evaluating sub expression. The associativity rule is applied when two or more operators of same precedence level appears in a sub-expression. Arithmetic expressions are evaluated from left to right using the rules of precedence. When parentheses are used, the expression within parentheses assume highest priority. Let's see the example. Consider A is equal to 5, B is equal to 4, C is equal to 3, and D is equal to 2. The expression is Y is equal to A plus B into C minus D. Let's put the value for corresponding variable. Y is equal to A is 5, so 5 plus 4 into 3 minus 2. In this expression, multiplication has the highest precedence compared to plus and minus. So multiplication is done first. That is 4 into 3. So this part is evaluated first. The answer for this is 12. So now the expression is Y is equal to 5 plus 12 minus 2. Now in this expression, we have only two operators, that is plus and minus. Plus and minus have same precedence. Just see the previous table. See here, plus and minus are having the same precedence. So the associativity go to left to right. So the evaluation is performed from left to right. So 5 plus 12 is 17 minus 2. So totally the value of y is 15. So this is the final resultant value. Let's see the second expression. X is equal to C into B plus B by D minus A into B. Just put the values of all these variables. That is X is equal to 3 into 4 plus 4 by 2 minus 5 into 4. In this expression, we have used brackets, then multiplication, plus and minus operators. So bracket has highest priority. So associativity is left to right. So first we need to evaluate the values which are there in the bracket. So order of evaluation goes from left to right. So first reduce this 3 into 4, that is 12. Next 4 by 2, that is 2. So next we have to evaluate the third part, that is 5 into 4, that is 20. Now the x value, x expression is x is equal to 12 plus 2 minus 20. In this expression we have plus and minus operators. Again here plus and minus are having the same priority, so the associativity goes from left to right. So evaluate this expression, that is 12 plus 2 is 14, 14 minus 20 is minus 6. So the final value of x is minus 6. Third expression, x is equal to 1 plus minus of c into b by d modulus c. So in this expression, parenthesis is having the highest precedence. So evaluate this value first. So minus c is nothing but minus 3. So here 1 plus minus of 3 into 4 by 2 modulus 3. So here plus of minus 3, that is minus 3. So minus 3 into 4, that is minus 12. Say this properly, x is equal to 1 plus or minus 3, so that is nothing but minus 3 into 4 divided by 2 modulus 3. So multiplication, division and modulus, see all these operators are having the same precedence, so associativity is considered left to right. So what is the expression now? X is equal to 1 minus 3 into 4, that is 12, divided by 2 modulus 3. So again left to right associativity, so 12 by 2 is 6. Next modulus 3, 6 mod 3, so modulus is nothing but remainder. So 3 2s are 6, remainder is 0. So now 1 minus 0, 1 minus 0 is 1. So the final value of x is equal to 1. So initially we have to consider the value in the parenthesis, that is minus. So minus into plus, so that is minus itself. So here minus 3. Now after reducing this, what are the other operators we have? That is 1 plus of minus 3, that is minus 3 into 4 divided by 2 modulus 3. So the associativity is left to right. So if I initially reduce this, then reduce the resultant value with this value, that is 2, then we need to consider its result and then mod 3. Finally 1 minus the result of this part, that is 1. So just go through the table which contains some of the main mathematical functions used in C with its description and some examples for it. So these are the, this table shows how to use sine, cos and tan functions in C.